Welcome guys, I am Parinita. Subscribe my channel and press the bell icon to receive regular notifications regarding the computer science topics and technical job updates. Hello guys, welcome to my channel to polish your CSE concepts with me. So let's get started. In today's video we are going to see an important algorithm, that is hill climbing algorithm or hill climbing procedure in artificial intelligence. Fine, in this video we will see in detail that what are the steps of hill climbing algorithm. This algorithm is the most important one. We will understand, we will try to understand it with the help of a diagram, and then we will also see that what are the main disadvantages or limitations that we are facing in case of this hill climbing algorithm. Fine, so let's get started. What is hill climbing algorithm? Let's understand this with this figure. It is very simple. What happens in hill climbing technique, that try to understand it as if we are having one hill, and what we are wanting is we want to find out the maximum point or the highest point in that hill. In simple words, hill climbing algorithm can be explained as, or it can be defined as, that hill climbing is actually a local search algorithm that continuously moves in the direction of increasing value to find the peak of the mountain or to find out the best solution of any problem. Fine, I hope you have understood it. This is written in very simple language, that in hill climbing simply we will be trying to find out the maximum point or the highest point in any hill, in the hill. Or it can also be taken as, this algorithm is used to find out the best solution to any problem. So what happens in hill climbing, like this hill is there, we will be, see these points I have shown you, they are also known as operators. So we will be taking different operators or different points on the hill. We will continuously keep on comparing two consecutive points. First of all, for example, let's take that this origin is itself a point. And so first of all, these two consecutive points will be compared, then whatever is better out of these two points, that better point and the next one will be compared, then again out of these two, whatever is the better point, with that better point the next point will be compared, and like this we will go on comparing the consecutive points unless we are finding the best solution or the goal state or the maximum state or the highest state of the hill. Got it? Unless we get the highest state or highest point, we will simply go on comparing two consecutive points with the help of this algorithm. And so this is the main aim that I told you, this is the main aim of hill climbing algorithm. Now let's see what are the algorithm steps or how we are going to move further. Fine, so what the algorithm says, the first step is to check the initial state. Initial state means, as I told, for example, let's take that this initial state is the origin. Here I've shown you with the help of axis, and this is the hill. So for example, this is my initial state. So first of all, what I will do is I will check my initial state. If it is the goal state, return and quit. Now what will be the goal state? My goal is to find the highest point. So goal state will be the highest point. So for my this example, this hill, let's say this is my goal state. So what I will do, I will first of all check my initial state. If my initial state is equal to goal state, if in the initial state itself I am getting the goal, then simply I will return and quit. My algorithm will end here. Fine. If not, then what I will do? I will look until a solution is found or there are no new operators to be left. Left to be like explored. Fine. If the initial state is the goal state, then I will simply return and quit. Simple. Now, if the initial state is not the goal state, then what will happen? Then I will loop until a solution is found or there are no new operators left. Means if my initial state is not the goal state, then I will continuously loop. Means I will continuously take all the further points and check correspondingly that if they are my goal state or not. Fine. So one by one operators or one by one points, I will take them and check them. The third is select and apply new operators. So as I told, we will be taking one by one operators or one by one points and will check if it is the goal state or not. Fourth, evaluate the new state. Means whatever, for example, I have already checked this origin, and second, I have taken this point. So whenever any new state or any new point is there, how to evaluate it? So the step to evaluate it is, if it is the goal state, it will be goal state. How to evaluate any new state? If it is the goal state, then quit. Simple. If this is my new state, I am checking it. If I am finding that this is my goal state, I can simply quit there. Okay, I will quit. If it is better than current state, if it is goal state, quit. Then simple. The algorithm will end here. But if it is not the goal state, what I will do? If it is better than current state, make it updated current state. Now, it is not the goal state, right? For example, this is the second state that we are exploring. Though it is not the goal state, but if I compare it with the previous state, I am finding out that this is the better state. So, what I can do, if this is the better state than the current one, then I will make this as the new current state. Fine. So, I will update it as the current state. Now, next. If it is not better, then go to second step. If it is not better, simply we will go back to the previous one and again I will start with this step, that is, I will loop until a solution is found or there are no operators left. Simple, got it? So, like this, one by one step we have to perform unless and until we are finding this best state or the highest point in the hill. Fine, so this is very simple hill climbing. This is the definition. This is the main technique how we are doing this, and these are the main algorithm steps that you have to remember, that with the help of these steps we will be finding the maximum point of the hill climbing. Now, one of the most important questions after understanding this is there any limitation in this hill climbing? Yes, there are some limitations or there are some challenging points in case of this hill climbing. So, what are these limitations? The main three limitations of hill climbing algorithm are these three: local maxima, plateau and ridge. These are the main three limitations of hill climbing. Now, why they are limitations? See, local maxima. First of all, let's talk about local maxima. Why we can say that this local maxima is a limitation? Because see, local maxima means whenever any hill is taking this kind of shape. See, these are the three main diagrams. With the help of diagrams, we will learn and we can explain to others also. In exam also, you can explain with the help of these diagrams that what happens in local maxima, that whenever this kind of diagram is there, whenever our algorithm, see what our algorithm will do, it will compare corresponding points here. So, after comparing all the points here, what our algorithm will get? Our algorithm will get that this is the highest point. Fine, because it will go on checking the corresponding points. Now, after coming to this point, the next points are again going down. So, after checking this much, what my algorithm will understand? My algorithm will understand that this is the maximum point. So, what may happen is our algorithm may say that this is the highest point. But actually, it will be wrong because this is actually the local maximum point. But here lies the global maximum point. So, this may be a challenging task for the algorithm, that the algorithm may be confused with this point. It may think that this point is actually the maximum point, but actually it is not. So, this is the local maxima problem that may occur. Now, the second problem is plateau. What happens in plateau? That this kind of thing will be present. That means all these points, there will be a big area where all the points are lying in the same plane. For example, here, this much part. What happens in this part? That the algorithm will continuously get the same values. This part can be like, here you are seeing only this much, but try to understand that this part is very big. So, what happens that for a very long time, the algorithm is going to get same values. So, like the algorithm will be confused that either there is any point bigger than this point coming in future, or this is the highest point. It will be confused that whether the algorithm needs to stop here or the algorithm needs to proceed, but after how much time it will get, there is no surety about that. Fine. So, if we are getting same values for a very long time or many points are same, the algorithm may get confused. That is known as plateau. The last one. So, the last limitation is ridge. So, what happens in ridge, as shown in the figure, like this? Equal height of hills will be there. So, what happens here, when the algorithm is applied on these hills, the algorithm will get all these points as the maximum points. So, the algorithm will get confused that out of these, which will be considered as the goal state or the maximum state. So, here also the algorithm may get confused or the algorithm may fail because it will not get exactly that which is our goal state, or taking which state as the goal state the algorithm should proceed. So this can also be one of the limitations of this hill climbing algorithm, that is ridge. So local maxima, plateau and ridge, these are the three main limitations of hill climbing algorithm. I hope you have understood the whole concept of hill climbing algorithm. If you like the video, please subscribe the channel and share it with your friends. And in case you still have any doubt, you can always ask in the comment section. Thank you so much.